Hey folks, we're doing another transcription video today. I have a little bit of time in between a couple of Skype lessons, so I thought I would go over to my YouTube comments and see if I could find a good idea. Kind of like this comment over here. Could you please do Home from the Forest Kick from Manzanita album? That's from Grasser82, and I think we're going to do that. I think that's my choice for today. It seems like something pretty easy and attainable that I can do in just a couple hours and I won't have to worry about too much. Another thing that's worth pointing out is that Grasser82 did not sponsor this video. I don't want you guys to feel like I'm only going to do videos when people pay for transcriptions and I have to do it that way now or something. And that I'll just do videos from comments too. You don't have to pay me for me to accept your video suggestions. All right, cool. I got the YouTube video queued up in front of me. I am going to be playing the actual recording in this video, which means that this video is likely going to be claimed for copyrighted content. So if you want to support me, you should go check out my website, lessonswithmarcel.com. You can check out the tab store. You can check out all of the merch we have there. We can check out some of those blog posts. And of course, you can sign up for Skype lessons. All of those things help keep this channel alive and they keep me from living on the streets. So I appreciate you checking out those things. And then I can continue to play some of this copyrighted music. So here we go. Let's listen to the kick. Okay, so let's talk about all the information that we can get just from listening to that. By the way, thanks to Bluegrass Tony Rice for uploading this in October of 2011. Just listening to this, I hear a lot of language that Tony only uses out of the C position. So we know that he's using C shapes right now. Especially like, I don't know if you guys can hear that double stop right there. So obviously the G string and the B string with first fret pushed down on the B string. Some of those little strums that are happening right there, they sound like C chords. But it doesn't really sound like, it doesn't sound like open C. And Tony doesn't play in open C a ton. He's normally capoed up to like second, third, fourth fret, right? He's up there. Those are my big predictions. Let's see if I'm totally wrong. If I'm hilariously wrong, that's fine with me as well. But let's pop that in for the guess. Cool, so let's go over to our transcribe screen. So this is where we're going to write down the whole transcription. I'm gonna go into my settings. Actually, let me show you this. I wanna make sure you guys know how to do this. So when I'm on YouTube here, there's a settings wheel and I can go to playback speed and I can select whatever I want, however slow I wanna make it, I can make that happen. So I'm gonna put it at like 0.75 and that's probably gonna be enough for me to hear this break. Capo 4, the kick goes into the 5, so a good guess would be. Alright, either I'm real out of tune or Tony's out of tune. Let's find out what it is. I think it's your fault this time, Tony. Tony, I think you're the one that's out of tune. Sounds like Tony's pretty significantly flat. It's all right. All right, cool, we're at least close to Tony. I'm gonna accept that. That sounds like it's the B string, the G string, and that double stop formation that I was talking about. It sounds like it's walking up into that fifth. Whoops. So it starts with an eighth note rest. This is an upstroke, and then we have quarter notes, three of them. Ba-do-do-do-do. Sounds like he's hitting some other strings too. We don't have to get super specific about that. So it feels like he's doing like a down, up, up, down. So how would I write that? Bum, 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 bum. Yeah, so let's assume something like this for now. I don't love this. I don't really believe this. Maybe it's because I'm not actually only hitting those two strings. Right, and this last one feels more like just strumming those two. Ba-da-da-ba-dum-bum, hammer on thing. So it hits the G string again. Let's make sure. Mm-hmm. Is it that same pattern? So we might go back and clean some of this up because I'm working pretty fast right now. But just like I talked about in my last video where I was doing a lot of this, I'm a really big fan of trusting your ear and cleaning up things later. Where if you're hearing things pretty close, write it down and move on. That's so much better than sitting there and like nitpicking all the tiny details and trying to figure them out in the moment. That's not a smart way to do it. You end up being so focused on these tiny moments that you don't really get anything done. So right, moments like that where you're like, wow, you figured that out fast. It's because Tony does it a lot, right? This is like classic language. So I'm not really searching my memory banks or anything to try to figure this out. I've written it down multiple times. I've seen it in multiple other transcriptions, and you'll get that way too if you do enough of this for sure. It feels like this is a big boy's drum, for lack of a better term. Cool, so let's count that. I feel like I hear this last like three beats, maybe some strumming in there, but let's not worry about that right now. Whoopsies. And then we get this little eighth note pickup. It's funny. I haven't heard this break a million times like some of the other ones. Not to make excuses or anything, but it's funny when you're writing something out and you're like, I just listened to it. What did it sound like? Sometimes too, when you're writing these, they feel like other famous things. Do 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 do. Like this sounds like that part in "Girl, I Look By Me." Right, it's the same kind of idea. It's nice when you can grab these from different places. Let's just say that again. So it is. It's an E and an F, and it walks up, and then we get this in the next line. Sounds like there's another quick note in there. I would guess that it's an F note just based on the chord change. Yeah, it definitely is. It sounds like that. Like maybe there's something like, oh, sorry, wrong chord. Maybe it's like strumming a little C here. And this should be a C note. I don't know why I did that. Ooh, E major, what's going on there? So this is something that I pointed out, I don't know, in a recent transcription or something, but this is something that Tony does a lot when he's going to different chords. It's like a move to an F chord. And whenever I hear that, right, I know that that's what's going on. It's classic kind of Church Street blues language. I don't know, there's another string here. Once again, something we'll clean up when we do like a close sort of attention to detail pass. Kind of a weird phrase there. I miss that. That's a weird phrase.
I'm doing something that I don't like to do right now, where I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm playing more of it than I've written down, and that's not a good spot to be, because you're gonna start sort of forgetting it. Something like that. Man, it's a funky measure. I don't know if you guys can hear that lightning and thunder. I guess thunder. Can't hear lightning, right? It's loud out there. So all of this is E chord. This is like the continuing adventures of the E chord. Oh, it is really raining out there. Maybe I'll show you in a second. That's because, you know, I start transcribing and I just can't stop now. All right, let me show you the rain. Look at that rain. Oh, mama. That is some rain. All right, cool. Back to it. We're so close. I really want to finish this thing. Let's go back to a reasonable speed. Does that sound right? Yeah, I think that's right. Okay, so we know that this is right where a G chord hits. He holds it and strums it for some amount of time. I think it was two measures. And we had some kind of a pickup here that was, I think, the open G string. That's as much as I got, though. It was something like that, though. Oh, maybe it's a D string. So let's count it again. Cool, so this lasts for a whole measure. And then that comes in on B3. Oh man, I cannot tell you how hard it is raining out there. It is wild.
Class field trip. That is some rain, boys. Look at this. All the transcribing stuff is waiting for me.
Okay, I hope you all enjoyed that class field trip. Let's write down the very last phrase in this transcription now. And then I'll know what to write down. So it's an amalgamation of a bunch of different classic Tony language, and right when you learn these breaks, that's what you kind of find. You kind of structure it in your mind like that as you go through it, right? And if you start organizing your thoughts kind of in the same way as Tony, that specifics become less important because you're going to come to the same conclusions that he comes to, just like you saw me do just now. Well, I feel pretty good about most of this, but now that my playback right now is on 0.5, so I'm at half speed. I listen to it all the way through and play along and try to spot any of those like tiny little things that I can fix and make this whole thing better, cleaner, smoother, stronger, faster, Daft Punk. Alright, so little things like this, like Tony likes to actually voice this upstroke before he gets into this stuff. It's not huge, it's still important to have it in there if people want to get exact. Right, so I definitely got this totally backwards right here. And I don't know if that was a writing mistake or a hearing mistake, but I wrote that wrong the first time that I went through. I was checking to make sure this is all sort of formatted correctly. I think it looks quite nice. That's an ending on right there. All right, so now that I wrote down that whole thing, we should probably do some kind of little performance. Here we go.
Oh, you're not ready to do a performance, buddy. You just barely wrote out the song. This is Marcel from the next day, and I think I'm gonna take care of the performance. right, thanks for watching. If you like taking a lesson from the biggest, baddest billy goat in the barnyard, please do all the normal things. Check out my website, lessonswithmarcel.com, for all those the tabs, the transcriptions that you can order. Of course, there's the merch, there's the tab store, and you can sign up for Skype lessons. There's all the lovely blog posts that all of our people write for us. I have no idea where to look or what to say. Also, check out Jazz and Grass with all of the licks. And man, I think that's it. I will see you next Wednesday for another Bluegrass YouTube video. See you all later. So right after I finished filming this video that you just watched, I lost all my power. So my power is out. I'm in the dark right now. I'm sure you can see that.
Nothing's on. The flooding, it killed my power. Midnight train.